Roy Fluker Jr. and his family claim they were in the business of helping people improve their lives. Postal inspectors say they would ask pastors if they could speak with their congregations directly. Their message was simple.
We're going to, you know, get people out of poverty. We're going to really help them out. And once you got into the pastors and got their trust, then the pastors would then kind of unknowingly work for them.
Fluker's investment program was called More Than Enough, and investors would get 25% of their total investment every month for a year.
If you invested $1,000, you get $250 after the first month.
He also offered a housing program for distressed homeowners.
They would say, if you can refinance or get a new loan, you give us all of your equity in your house that you have, we'll invest it, and then you would take, for 6 months, you wouldn't have to make any payments, and then after that 6 months, you would make half payments, and we would make the other payments, and then in 5 years, your entire house will be paid off.
The pitch worked.
This wasn't legitimate at all. They would basically trick the people into turning over all their equity in their home. And some of these people got foreclosed on and really got hurt.
More than 3,000 victims lost their savings and their homes. Losses exceeded $9 million.
These people who run these Ponzi schemes are con artists. They're going to get in, they're going to try to convince you that this is a good thing.
Some advice from postal inspectors. Take the time to do your research. A simple online search would have raised a red flag.
The internet is a wonderful thing. You can search, and if you had searched Roy Fluker Jr., you would have found that there was a similar scheme that was happening up in Michigan that he was kind of caught on. So there would have been a little red flag that there's something going on here that's just not right.